From inside Tropicana Field here in Tampa Bay, we've got the American League Championship Series on the show. It's the Seattle Mariners taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. Alongside Chris Singleton, I'm John Shombe. And a lot riding on this one as these teams meet for game two, Chris.
And the series started out like you might expect, the home side taking care of business in game one. But this game today is going to reveal a lot about what this series will become. Will it be a battle for six or seven games, or will it be a walkover? Those are the questions that we start getting more clarity on after game two.
I have a feeling it's going to be a good one, Chris. This should be fun. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. So just about set now, and starting this one, Shane McClanahan.
He's a dominant pitcher, but he can get a little too relaxed second and third time through the order and miss his spots. That's where we see him get touched up. If he maintains the same intensity that he has in the first inning and the second inning, I think we'll see him hand the ball over to his closer.
All right, ready to get underway. Here's Adam Frazier. Next offering is in for a strike. And that one is lifted in the air. Nice grab on the run. One down. And here's the first baseman, Ty France. One down, base is empty. No score, just getting started, top of the first. Swing and a miss, struck him out, two down.
I got to think that was the plan all the way. He set him up with the high fastball and then bury that curveball down low to get him swinging. Now, especially with how effective pitchers work up in the zone these days, that's a devastating combination.
Here's Jesse Winker. He's someone that really beats up on right-handed pitching. The lefties, however, give him a little bit more trouble. The other way, and he beats the shift. And now it rolls all the way to the wall. Winker into second, and he's got it doubled.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Now batting Mitch Haniger. And a pitch.
Well, you always want to come out in the first inning, try to put something up on the board. It's a big two-out double right there. See if the cleanup man can drive him in and put a tally up there on the board.
Runner at second, two down. Next one misses, and the count's full.
Well, they're looking to get on the board first here after that clutch two-out double made this inning interesting.
Back to work, 3-2 now. Hard ground ball, base knock. Here comes Winker. Now a long throw home. Edper slides safe at the plate, and it's 1-0.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield.
So two down, and Eugenio Suarez up to hit down. That misses the zone, and that's ball two. Hey. Haniger off of first with two away. Swing and a miss. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. And there's a ball.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Swing and a ball lifted in the air left field. Pretty well struck. And it's gone. Home run. Eugenio Suarez blasts one out. His second homer of this series. It's 3-0.
You see how he stays square to the plate. He takes a breaking ball that's away, gets around it, gets it up in the air, and hits a long home run. Not exactly the way that you teach it in the cage, but you'll take the result.
J.P. Crawford gets a chance to hit. The pitch. Up the middle. Lau sends it to first. That's the third out. But they strike for three in the inning. Two on this two-run home run. It's now 3-0. Bottom of the first. And starting this one is Logan Gilbert.
Well, he throws the change in the slider off the fastball. I really like how he's able to sell fastball, but it's really change up and keep hitters just out in front a little bit. Swing and miss, soft contact. The slider as well comes out of the same tunnel. All three very deceptive, and hitters are going to have to stay back and make sure they get pitch recognition.
We go to the bottom of the first, and stepping in for the Rays, Brandon Lau. That one fouled off. Kicks and fires. And now 2-2. Good eye right there.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Throws to first. Lau out on the play.
Batting second. The shortstop. Wander.
Here's Wander Franco. And here comes. That's off the mark. Counts full, 3-2. Line drive. Oh, he gloves it.
Wow, that was an awesome leaping catch. Great reactions, great athleticism, and he snatched that thing out of the air, and he robbed him of a base hit.
Two outs, base is empty. Now it's Austin Meadows. And a pitch. Swing and blast one down the line. It's gone if it's fair, but it hooks foul.
Oh, it's a really good pass of the ball right there. Just a little bit too quick. He's got to find a way. Just let it travel a hair more.
Swing and a high fly ball left field. Squeezes it. And that is the third out of the inning. Down in order go the Rays. They trail in this one 3-0. All set for the start of the inning. Here's the center fielder, Kyle Lewis. And so the lefty allows the leadoff free pass.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Here's Jared Kelnick. Here comes a pitch. That's down and in. And there's a strike. Saying he wasn't very sharp in the first, got hit around a little bit, just wasn't able to locate particularly well. A lot of stuff in the fat part of the plate.
Yeah, Boog, he wasn't fooling anyone. It's a tough place to be because it's not always obvious what adjustments need to be made. Sometimes it's location, sometimes it's being too predictable. Sometimes you're tipping your pick.
Off balance feed, there's one. Throw to first, but he beat it. Man at first. Now it's Tom Murphy. And a pitch. That misses. And now 3-1. And that's ball four.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
The batter, the second baseman.
So the batting order turns over. Next to hit, Adam Frazier. Ball and a strike. Ground ball right side, could be two. To Franco for one. What a double play that was. Inning over. Now to the bottom of the second. It's the Mariners 3, the Rays nothing. Bottom half of inning number 2, and here is Randy Arozarena.
The Rays in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
Righty delivers. And down on strikes he goes. Now one away.
No, that's not the best two-strike fastball I've seen, but certainly got away with the location there. You know, sometimes as a hitter, when you're down in the count, you're so focused on a pitcher painting the black, and you just get a little bit locked up on something down the heart of the plate, not expecting it, and it just kind of freezes you.
And now the hitter, G-Man Choi. And now 2-1. Foul ball there. Breaking ball inside. 3-2 now. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
Yandy Diaz now. Choi, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Check swing, no appeal.
That pitch wasn't even close, and they still got a check swing out of it. He's going to have to make an adjustment and make it fast.
At the belt and fires. And a foul ball, he stays alive.
He's mixing his pitches really well. Late on that fastball after seeing the changeup. See if he can elevate one. I think if he does, he'll get the swing and miss.
That one the other way. And a base hit right there. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
Here's Manuel Margot, and now maybe extra bases. And that one's going to get into the corner. The throw is wild, and it gets away. One run is in.
You got to get on your horse and get to that thing and get it back in, because he's going to come barrel around first. He's going to put pressure on you. If you bobble it or you don't get there in a hurry, he's going to make you look silly and end up on second base.
One down. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Mike Zunino. The pitch. Got him. Two gone.
Wow, just great bite to that slider. Broke hard out of the zone, and he just couldn't hold up the swing. You know, as a hitter, that pitch is really hard to take, and there's just not much you can do with it. You know that, but you don't want to get rung up by the umpire.
Here's Kevin Kiermaier. And the right-hander deals. Swung on, belted. Way back there. Makes the catch up against the wall. Rays get an RBI double. It's now a 3-1 ball game. Welcome back. Top half of the third inning, and stepping in for the Mariners, Ty France.
Well, he's back out here for the third, and after the first couple of innings, pretty rough. I think the skipper's looking for him to give him a little bit of length, see if he can save the bullpen some.
Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Well, when you commit to throwing an inside fastball to your glove side across the strike zone, especially with two strikes, if you're going to miss, you want to miss off the plate in. You do not want to leave it out over the heart of the plate. So that was excellent execution on that pitch. Really tied him up, and he couldn't get a piece at all.
And here is Jesse Winker. Gathers and throws to first. Two up, two down.
Up next for Seattle, the right fielder, Mitch Haniger.
And now it's the cleanup hitter for the Mariners, Mitch Haniger. One for one with a single and a run scored so far. Oh, that ball got him pretty good out there on the mound. In there safely. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. Next offering upstairs. And a pitch. That's outside. Now 3-1. The pitch. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. kicks and deals. Smash to the left side. Gets it to first, and that'll do it. Mariners lead one, as the lead remains 3-1. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Lau at the plate. Next pitch, not close, up high.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a miss. That's strike two.
Love to see it. Power versus power right there.
And down on strikes. And that's the first out. Now batting Wander Franco. 0-for-1 so far. And a 1-1. Line drive. Makes the grab, and there's two out.
Designated hitter, Austin Meadows.
At the plate, Austin Meadows. Flied out his first time. Here's a 1-1. Awkward swing there from the big left-handed hitter.
Off balance as well.
A wind in the pitch. Good eye right there. Stays alive.
Clearly trying to stay back a little bit longer for that changeup as he fouls that fastball back.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. And that one in the air, center field. Lewis settles underneath it, puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. Nothing doing for Tampa. Score holds. It's 3-1. New inning getting started. And now for Seattle, J.P. Crawford. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Margot brings it in, and there's one down. And up next for Seattle, Kyle Lewis. He reached out a walk his first time. And now the lefty got him. And now two gone.
With that kind of velocity, an elevated fastball, even if it's still in the strike zone, can be tough for hitters to get on top of.
Jared Kelnick up next for the Mariners. The wind of the pitch. That one pulled foul.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, it will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
Next offering is foul back.
Well, he hasn't gotten the result yet, but it's got to feel pretty confident. Three foul balls in a row. He's right on this guy.
Stays alive. Next pitch misses, and the count's even at two. On the ground, Diaz gloves it, sends it across to first, and that will end the inning. Mariners are down in order, and the score stays 3-1. Back now in Tampa Bay. Now it's Randy Arozarena.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
Hit in the air, right field. Haniger under it, hauls it in, and there's one away.
The batter, the first baseman, G-Man Choi.
Now up for Tampa Bay, G-Man Choi. Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Siggy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
And he deals. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Snags it for the second out.
Now batting, third baseman, Yandy Diaz.
Two outs, base is empty. And stepping in for the Rays, Yandy Diaz. Turned on, but that's foul down the third baseline.
Look out, that ball was smoked. Man, I am so relieved that they have this netting down the lines. Just ensure safety.
The punch out there. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Rays held in check here, and they still trail it here 3-1. Back here at Tropicana Field, top five, John Schaube with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Tom Murphy. And he walked him.
Perfect. Second walk of the game for him, and he's been really patient at the plate, a game plan that he's sticking to. He's just not going outside of what he's looking for up there.
Back to the top of the lineup, Adam Frazier up next for the Mariners. Here's a 2-1. Here's the pitch. Runner goes. Next offering is fouled back.
Well, Boog, after watching the first inning of this one, you would not have expected that this pitcher would be in such a groove and still in the ballgame at this point.
And a swing and a miss. One away.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
And now, Ty France. Swing and a miss. And a count 1-2. Kicks and fires. That misses, and the count is 2-2. The pitch. In the air out to center. He's got it, and there's two away.
Now that designated hitter, Jesse Winter.
Man at first. Now it's the DH, Jesse Winker. 1-2. Here's a high chopper. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. One left for Seattle, but they still lead it 3-1. Bottom of the inning. Now it's the right fielder, Manuel Margot. Next offering is fouled back. 1-2 to Margot. Soft contact in the air. So Margot is aboard.
Wasting no time. He's 2-for-2 now on the night. And just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. Here's Mike Zunino. He's built his reputation as one of the top framers in the sport. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
Margot gets his lead at first with nobody out. Pickoff throw, and Margot back in. And now 2-2. This one popped up. France moving under it. Hauls it in for the out.
Boy, that was a hanging breaking ball right there. I think he tried to do a little bit too much. Sometimes those eyes can get really big. I think his swing broke down as well, and that's what caused him to pop it up.
Here's Kiermaier now. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Left-hand batter waits. He swings and fouls one off. Tying run at the plate. On the ground a second, might be two. To Crawford for one. On to first, double play, and that's the inning.
Well, the second baseman made that one look easy. Great feed to the shortstop. Shortstop completes the play. They get out of a jam, and they end the inning.
We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Ryan Thompson. It's his job to keep his team in the game.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he needs a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Back here at the ballpark, all set for the top of the sixth. And now the right fielder, Mitch Haniger. Ground ball up the middle. The throw to first. And they take care of Haniger for the out.
Now that third baseman, Eugenio Suarez.
The 1-1. Suarez now in the box. Comes up empty with a swing there. Bullpen activity starting up now. Matt Whistler getting ready to go. And a swing and a miss. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
Well, when you throw the same pitch back to back, that's how you want to do it. Set him up in the strike zone, then extend a little bit from there and see if you can get him to chase. Nicely done with the slider right there.
Two outs, base is empty. J.P. Crawford up next for the Mariners. The 1-1.
Two balls, one strike.
Now a high fly ball out to left center. A Rosarena makes the catch, and that'll do it. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Mariners 3, the Rays 1. And welcome back. Bottom of the sixth inning. Here's the Rays leadoff hitter, Brandon Lau. The 1-1. And that's in for a strike. Movement in the bullpen. Anthony Misevich, a lefty, looks to be getting himself ready. The 1-2. Sliced hard but foul. And the righty deals. And now it's even up.
Definitely a swing and miss slider down and in. He finished that really well. Just couldn't get him to offer at it.
Next offering is fouled back. The 2-2. Next offering misses down and away. This one in the air, center field. Lewis settles underneath it, and there's one down.
The batter, number 5, shortstop, Wander.
And here comes the Mariners manager to the mound. Pitching change coming. Logan Gilbert done for the night. Two-run ball game as he heads for the dugout, and we'll be back with a new pitcher. Here's a new pitcher from the pen, Eric Swanson. He's into the game with the bases empty.
Number 50, Eric Swanson.
Now here is Wander Franco. Next offering is fouled back. Next pitch way upstairs.
Well, with both starters out of the game, this quickly becomes a bullpen game, and this is something we see more and more in the game today, especially in the postseason.
Lewis under it. He makes the catch, and there's two down. Here is Austin Meadows. The pitch. Comebacker to the mound. Crawford collects it. Over to first. And that is the inning. Down in order go the Rays. And it remains a 3-1 ball game. Matt Whistler gets the call from the pen, and he'll do his best to keep this close. We go to the top of the seventh, and stepping in for the Mariners, Kyle Lewis. Thank you. here it comes. This one in the air right field. Margot on his way over makes a nice running catch.
And there's one away.
So digging in, Jared Kelnick. Next offering is fouled back. And a pitch. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. That's out number two. Two outs, base is empty. And now the catcher comes up to him, Tom Murphy. Two down, nobody on. And that one fouled off. Righty to the plate. And a ball evens the count.
Back count, two and two.
The pitch. Lifted in the air, right field. Margot racing over to make the catch. Nobody left for Seattle as the lead remains 3-1. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Andres Munoz. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise. Bottom of the seventh, and now here's a speed threat. Outfielder Randy Arozarena. The 2-1. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
It's been tough for the offense so far, but you can't get frustrated. You got to find a way to shake it off, go up there, and relax. That's the only way you're going to be able to put runs up on the board.
And that one ripped to left. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And there's one down.
Now batting, first baseman, G-Man Choi.
G-Man Choi, next to hit for the Rays. He's 0 for 1. The kick, the 3-2. And there's ball four.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Runner on at first with one gone. Yandy Diaz next to hit for the Rays. And a pitch. Ground ball left side, could be two. Off balance feed, there's one. Double play. They can't seem to break through. Inning over.
They made it look easy, but it started with a nice feed to the second baseman from the shortstop. Perfect turn, and they're out of this jam.
Now on the mound for the Rays, Jeffrey Springs. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance. We go to the eighth. Now here is Adam Frazier. And the pitch.
Ball two. Two balls, one strike. Count.
Strike two.
Two balls, two strikes.
Next offering is fouled back. Swing and a ball popped up. Franco makes the catch. One down.
Now batter, the first baseman, Ty France.
And now for Seattle, Ty France for the fourth time tonight. the 3-1. Bounced up the middle. In plenty of time to first. Two up, two down here in the top of the eighth.
Now that designated hitter, Jesse Winker.
Now it's the Mariners DH, Jesse Winker. And fouled off. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, Boog.
Two outs, runner at first. Mitch Haniger, the next to hit. And a pitch. And now one and two. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
1-2 now. On the ground, right side. To first. And they take care of Haniger for the out. Third out. Mariners lead one. And the score stays 3-1. So out of the bullpen for the Mariners, Diego Castillo. He's into the game to face his former team. Welcome back. Out of the bottom of the eighth. And now, Manuel Margot. The next offering misses. The count now 2-2. The pitch. And Marco able to spoil that one.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
Hit weakly on the ground. And foul ball. Right-handed reliever. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Here comes a pitch.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
Up the middle, into the outfield, base hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
But when you see that many pitches in an at-bat, your chances of succeeding go up. And right there, we see the result.
Mike Zunino, next to hit for the Rays. Next pitch off the play. And a count 2-1.
Now these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
Next pitch inside. Ball three. Chris, with that distraction and the speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
At the belt and fires. And that one fouled off. Margot gets his lead at first. Nobody out. The tying run at the plate. And a swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Kevin Kiermaier. Singing, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. Next offering misses. Two balls and a strike. Left-hand hitter waits. Up the middle, and that one finds its way through. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out.
Well, that at bat had a lot of pressure riding on it, so really great job coming through right there. It's got to feel good. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
So they turn things over to the righty, Drew Steckenrider, and he'll work on holding this lead. So the Rays batting order turns over, and now it's Brandon Lau. And there's no doubt that they'll feed off the energy from this crowd, right?
I mean, yeah, I'd say the intensity level has gone up a few notches for sure. These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there. Sometimes being lucky is a swing and miss. If he makes contact with that pitch, probably hits into a double play.
Tried to check his swing. Appeal to third. No swing. Just held it back there. Three, two now. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boyd. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
So bases loaded with one away. Wander Franco next to hit for the Rays. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, Boyd, not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at bat that could change the course of this game dramatically.
1-1 now. And that one wrapped foul.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
And the right-hander deals. Action in the bullpen for Seattle. Paul Sewald getting loose out there. Romo getting loose as well. Two, two. Stays alive. So the tying run at second. Foul ball. Two, two now. And a foul ball. He stays alive. A swing and a miss. Huge strikeout there. Now it's Austin Meadows.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
The pitch. Fly ball down the line. Double now as it hops the wall and foul ground as they score a pair on the play.
You don't want to get greedy, but it's easy to imagine all three runners coming home to score with this type of contact. Yeah, the automatic double costs them a run, but they're still in a position to keep scoring.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Randy Arozarena. Two on, two outs. Next offering is outside.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter. Don't worry about anything else.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And another ball
Good pitchers make pitches in big situations, and right here with a middle of the order hitter up, runner in scoring position, he's got to find a way to throw a quality strike.
He swings and hits a fly ball center field. That's back. One run across, bangs off the wall. Runner from second crosses the plate, and they take a two-run lead.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like you did right there.
New pitcher for the Mariners, Sergio Romo. A runner on second to deal with. He'll do his best to keep him there. So a man aboard, and now the first baseman, G-Man Choi. Man on second, two down. And down on strikes he goes. That's out number three. Game two heads to the ninth inning. It's the Rays 5 and the Mariners 3. Andrew Kittredge on to pitch here, and he'll do his best to hang on to this lead. Well struck, right field. Way back there. Out of here. He made him pay for that one. He's up to 3 home runs in the series. And they slice into the lead. It's 5-4.
When you see a guy take a slider on the outside part of the plate and hit an opposite field home run, fires you up, because not only is he flexing the muscles to show the pop, that kind of approach, you'll hit for a high average as well.
J.P. Crawford up next for the Mariners. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And he deals. Out to short. Franco picks it up. In there. He's safe.
Well, from the time you're a little leaguer, you're taught to hustle out of the box and give it a full sprint through the base, regardless of how you hit it. And he didn't make great contact, but the effort was there, and he earns the base hit.
Substitution now at first base. And here's the pinch runner, Billy Hamilton. No outs, runner at first. Kyle Lewis now at the plate.
If you're a base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
1-2 now. That one missed.
This is the guy they turn to get the most important outs of the ball game, but they're going to make him work to get this save.
One run game here in the top of the ninth. Next pitch is outside. And the righty deals. Strike three, got him swinging. One away.
It's a good breaking ball there, just off the corner where you can't really do much damage, but it's close enough to where you've got to protect, and he just couldn't find a way to fight it off.
So up next, Jared Kelnick. In the air, out towards left center. Kiermaier makes the play, and there's two down.
So here's Murphy now.
Well, with pretty good speed over there at first base, I think the pitcher's got to slow everything down. Hold the ball a little bit, step off, just try to break the rhythm and timing of a potential base stealer.
Kittredge keeping him close.
Well, at least you got the pitcher thinking a little bit. You don't want to run yourself out of the ball game. You get thrown out or picked off, it's over.
Next offering is down low, and it's 2-1. Kicks and deals. Late on that fastball.
He can live up in the zone all game if guys will chase it. That's just too much velocity. Hitters got to look down in the zone.
Righty delivers. Hamilton takes off. Throw. Save. Zanino not in time with the throw. Bounce to the right side. Throw to first. Ball game. And the Rays get it done at home, taking games 1 and 2 of the series.
Well, he does a nice job of coming in and getting the save. He made a mistake with the pitch, gave up the solo home run, but he maintained his focus to push through to the finish line.
So, Chris, here's a look at the final numbers from what turned out to be a really close ball game.
Yeah, this is one of those games that clearly could have gone either way, and that's kind of exactly what you expect out of postseason baseball. So competitive.
Close one here today, and your final 5-4. They hang on to win it by a run. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciambi, saying so long from Tampa Bay.
The final line score for our ball game tonight, for the victorious Rays, 5 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Mariners, 4 runs on 6 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 12 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance, a sellout of 31,042. The Rays thank you and hope you'll join us again real soon at Tropicana Field.